I can't stress how important it is to stay fit. I've never met a serious rider who was out of shape. You must be able to climb, crawl into tight spaces, and stay light on your feet. Being agile and able to run for a long period of time is a must. Otherwise, you'll sit in a cell once shit hits the fan. Many of the systems that get regularly painted are basically risk-free. As soon as you step outside of the comfort zone and into the third world countries, the consequences are more severe. Anything from the risk of being shot, beaten to a pulp, tortured, or a long stay in a foreign jail. We risk everything just to collect these systems, and just for a pure adrenaline rush. We're always pushing it to the limit. I've been tortured in jails, hunted by Interpol, come close to even dying a few times, all because of graffiti. But I wouldn't change it for anything. These are the experiences that mold you into who you are through and through. This is just an abridged version of my life over the last years. The people I've met, friends I've made, and the places I've been. At the end of the day though, this is still nothing special. I was staying with my good friend Richie in Amsterdam when his friend Ekin from Budapest came to visit him. I didn't know it then, but Ekin would become one of my best friends. We got drunk and ate mushrooms together and did panels that night. We agreed to keep in touch when I started my interrail.
Friends again. Everybody has some freaked out and
I fucking time. Painted this. I painted this 2 hours ago and it's online. One week later, Ekin called me asking if I wanted to join him on a road trip to sell his book throughout several countries. So I took a train to Budapest and met him there. I had no idea what to expect. As I stepped off the train, the scent of goulash and paprika filled the air. The old architecture and shady unkept buildings in the evening light gave me the impression that I had gone back in time. The rusty old subway looked like it was about to fall apart. Communism had obviously taken its toll. We'll be right back. with acid and drove to our first destination, Hamburg. Hamburg was a good time, like always. I met some new friends and saw some old friends as well. We had a crazy chase out of the hangar, but everybody escaped. We left for Berlin the next day. Traveling through Germany was easy. We had a German number plate, so we never got pulled over by the cops. It was agreed that if I wanted to continue to travel, though, I would have to steal all the diesel for the car. So I did. By the end of our trip, I had stolen over 3,000 euros worth of premium diesel. Acid's car engine died a week later.
Shit.
We stopped in Bremen to see some friends, paint, and let the Berliners know that we would be coming soon. Berlin was exactly what you would expect. Endless possibilities to paint, as well as to take in some European history. Ecken introduced me to Ryder and Schmuck, who became my partners in crime anytime I would return. Berlin was my second home, and thanks to my friends there, it will probably stay that way.
Ach so, okay. Kann ich auch ins Gesicht kacken?
Alles frisch.
M.A.E. Felgen Jeep unterm Arsch und hinter deinem Arsch sehr viel Muftaras. Kehr gerade bis Bonn im Benz Facelift Modell. Bringt den Leuten das Giftigste. Hey, sind's Hotel. Hier gibt's keine Freunde wie Siegfried und Roy. Ihr wollt ein Grabim, aber kriegt nur 09 Maroks, die mit knetbaren Sumi-Platten am Gummiplatz am Tag paar Hunis machen. Sobald im Benz paar Ausländer fahren sind, Kripus auf der Jagd im VW Charan. Weil wir schon in jungen Jahren Erfolg haben, tragen manche Goldzahn und fahren mit Neuwagen, also Wallis-Nutte. Wir fahren nur Karren mit Karosserie-Vertiefungen und dann ganz laut den Beat pumpen, Arm raus bis zum Boden, Trizeps angespannt und schief gucken. Mach dein ABQ aus, SIM-Karte raus, Flubis fließt, du siehst mich nicht. Was Benz transportiert im Opel Kadett, jeder Ortika denkt, voila, CEO mach schlau. Mach dein ABQ aus, SIM-Karte raus, Flubis fließt, siehst mich nicht, was Benz transportiert im Opel Kadett. Jeder Ottiker denkt, was für CEO macht schlau. Bei Hartz IV Rentnern gebunkert ist Petra. Jungs holen nur Binderzahlen nur mit 5er und 10er. Leute hören uns sogar in Bangkok am Block. Nuttensohn, komm und du landest am Bonner Loch. Machst mit Bubble schnelles Para oder hängst da mit ner Nadel in der Ader. Kanacken ohne Papiere verdienen auf der Straße stabil mit ner Biese. Funkelndes Flap, Bigs in Packs, alles ein Stein. Mit mehr Weisheit als Albert Einstein. Aufstehen, nach Haus gehen mit Bomben, Bilanzen. Fotzen mit Wampen, die sich boxen wie Kanten. Manche sind schwanger und trotzdem am Basen. Finanziert werden dadurch Felgen von Braytons. Weil ich ohne Pause acker, rauch ich Sattler. Bau nur mit American Spirit Tabak. SSIO. Alles oder nix, nimmt sich alles und auf dich.
The very next day, your friend and humble narrator was a free man.
Brussels was one of the easiest missions that I painted. Ecken lived there when he was younger, so he had a good plan of the system. Our crewmate Quiet was also living there at the time, so he knew the place like the back of his hand. After a few panels, we moved on to Paris. At this point, I was a professional petrol thief. I was taking over 50 liters at a time. Start by saying that it's impossible to describe all that Paris has to offer in such a short time. The history of Paris is complex and dark as the tunnels that run beneath it. I don't know if there's any one person who truly knows all the secrets of the subway system there, especially since they mix up the catacombs, the winding streets, the magnificent infrastructure, and the multicultural atmosphere make Paris appealing to just about everybody, but it gets old fast. Just avoid les banlieues and you should be fine.
Ha 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 ha.
On demande le respect à personne. MTP connaît la méthode. On peut la coucher pour un petit somme. Te coucher pour une grosse somme. Ma technique arrive du deublé. Armé, prêt à partir en reggae. Aveuglé par les chiffres en 2D. Gravé sur les billets en revêt. C'est plus que du peur, tu le sais, tu l'admets. Des ennemis, on n'aura jamais assez. Je vais pas me faire chier tout seul au sommet. Donc je prends mon temps pour les effacer. Elles aiment le pognon, elles aiment la vitesse. J'explique un texto quand j'ai envie de sexe. Viens me voir si t'as la migraine. Je vais faire semblant de planter la petite graine. On est sur les nerfs. On est sur les nerfs. Je vais baisser un peu le micro, s'il te plaît. On est sur les nerfs. Yeah. Ramène ta bite, j'apprends un sandwich avec le négro qui partage ma tête. Man, elle vient pas de Colombie, mais cette blanche me massacre la tête. Man, elle me reçoit 7 sur 7. Sors ma hug, j'ai mes têtes sur tête. J'ai une nasse verte, j'ai une ceinture verte. J'ai la peau noire, j'ai une ceinture noire.
Alléluia, la concurrence fait engloutir par des trouloirs. J'suis dans un grépois, échange juste en taille des pions, les fumoirs. J'vois des couverts dans les couloirs. Tous mes négros sont allumés. Tape quoi cette merde, c'est une poêle du nez. Le loup-garou est ma lune. On est sur les nerfs, on est sur les nerfs. On est sur les nerfs, on est sur les nerfs. On est sur les nerfs, on est sur les nerfs.
After over 2 weeks of driving, painting, stealing, fighting, and sleeping on couches and floors, Akin went back home to Budapest and I went to Amsterdam. As soon as I had recharged and rested, Richie and I took a train to Rome. By far one of my favorite destinations. Italy has been in a crisis for years due to their unstable economy. As far as I could see, nobody gave a shit about anything. It was amazing to see remains of an ancient civilization being used as dwellings for gypsies and prostitutes. The gladiators would be turning in their graves. It's funny to me thinking that we could paint a subway system and watch our pieces go into traffic directly under the Vatican City. With the insane and violent locals, Rome is an inferno for tourists. Not to mention the sadistic Metro Guards, who are famous for beating, torturing, and shooting graffiti writers.
Yes! Ah!
Man,
Italia! Hello!
Thank you.
Madrid's the capital of Spain, making it their most heavily policed city. Since the bombings in Atocha, security levels in the metro have increased significantly. The only thing is, Spain is full of Spanish people, who are more or less the most insane graffiti writers on the planet. Not to discredit them, some of the best and most hardcore graffiti I've ever seen was painted by Spanish graffiti writers. And anytime we go on a mission with them, there's always an interesting story in the aftermath.
I'm not afraid to
Barcelona, Spain. I have never been drunk for so many consecutive days in a row before visiting this city. The hot weather, the hot beaches, and the cheap alcohol make this a crazy destination for anybody. Whoever said that New York was the city that never sleeps has clearly never been to Barcelona. The police are present almost everywhere, but you're usually able to talk your way out of most situations and get over anyway.
Nobody called.
And we just wanna paint here.
I had been to Kiev twice before the war with Russia started. This time I was flying there knowing that things are going to be even worse than before. The Ukrainian systems are notoriously difficult, and the country itself is volatile, to say the least. When I arrived, the border guard simply looked at my passport, shook his head, and stamped me through. The streets at Maidan were literally on fire. Ekin would arrive the next day. The night he arrived, we painted the mission knowing we could be shot on suspicion of being Russian terrorists if we were seen in the tunnel. We pulled off the whole cars, but they kept the train in the tunnel so we could not get traffic photos. The next day, photos of my wagon appeared online in a Kiev police blog. Thank you. Ekin and I went back to Budapest and celebrated the action. We went to the Balaton Lake for the music festival, Balaton Sound. Somebody there put drugs in my drink, and I had already taken enough MDMA, speed, and cocaine to put a horse on its ass. Needless to say, I overdosed and had a heart attack. My liver failed as well. I was in the hospital overnight. They released me the next day and insisted that I rest for 2 weeks. My blood intoxication levels were 2.3% methamphetamine. You heard me. Instead of relaxing, I did what was probably the last thing I should have done and hopped on a 24-hour bus with Ekin to go to Athens for the Metro Jam. Athens was hot, crowded, and full of graffiti. We met with the BM45 crew at the hotel, as well as all the other usual suspects. The city had no idea what was about to hit it. We did 3 whole trains, 4 full end-to-ends, and countless panels. The problem was that my left arm started going numb, and I almost passed out in the middle of outlining a whole car on the platform. I cut myself on the way out, and my blood did not clot for hours. I fainted the next day. I flew back home and checked into the hospital. They told me I was in critical condition and that my body was struggling to function normally.
I'm not
I took several months off of anything stressful until Ekin called me one day and told me he was going to South America and wanted me to go with him. Juan was a great start to the trip. It was sunny every day, and we stole all of our food from Walmart. We would hit the beach during the day and check the subway out at night. We hit the yard on a Tuesday morning, and we had to cross through the jungle. Huge spiders, wild horses, giant lizards, and poisonous plants were everywhere. The next night, we hit the elevated line spot. It was too dark to film anything, but it was a good action. Later that night, our car broke down, and the Puerto Rican transvestites fixed it.
Don't run. Hey, take the shit, take the shit. Hey!
Hey! Get photos?
No. Let's go. Fast, run.
They don't chase us.
No.
Mexico. After a week of drugs, strippers, and steak dinners with the cartel in Monterrey, we moved on to Mexico DF. It was a vast, dirty city, and the metro was even more beautiful than we imagined. We met with our contact, Stunter. This guy was fucking crazy. He took it to another level by painting political messages on the metro, and for that, he was public enemy number one. The first night we arrived, we painted in the Zaragoza hangar on Christmas Eve. What better present could you ask for? A panel on one of the nicest models out there.
A mujeres no me falta ni el dinero ni el amor. Jineteando en mi caballo por la sierra yo me voy. Las estrellas y la luna ellas me dicen dónde voy. Ay, 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 mi amor.
cantar el sol. Mariachi me acompaña cuando canto mi canción. Me gusta tomar mis copas, aguardiente es lo mejor. También el tequila blanco con su sal le da sabor. Ay, 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 mi amor. Ay, mi morena de mi corazón. Me gusta tocar guitarra, me gusta cantar el sol. El mariachi me acompaña cuando canto mi canción. Me gusta tomar mis copas, aguardiente es lo mejor. También el tequila blanco con su sal le da sabor. Ay, 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 mi amor. Ay, mi morena de mi corazón.
Second night, we tried a second action in the hangar in Rosario. We got into a very bad chase and escaped by the skin on our teeth. The cops chasing us were wearing black riot gear and were carrying M16s. They would have beaten us to a pulp had they caught us. That was it for me. I stuck to the streets after that, in Mexico anyway. Within 2 hours of being in Panama City, we had figured out how to paint the system. It was no joke. We had to paint on an elevated track, 70 feet in the air, above the highway, outside the city. I had been in bed the entire day from food poisoning, but I stopped shitting and vomiting in time to paint. I was dehydrated, and I swore that I was hallucinating while we were entering the spot, but I kept that to myself. Adrenaline took over, and we painted for 10 minutes. Second hit, but the first ones to do it in traffic. Our next stop was Santiago de Chile. At one point, there were 14 of us driving around trying to enter the spots in one of the hardest systems in South America. After 2 weeks, we pulled it off in Barrancas. Unfortunately, I think lost the footage from this action, but we have the photos, which is the most important thing. However, he did a very good action by himself.
We'll be right back. entregarle a la ciudadanía arte, y claramente esto no es arte. El graffiti es un arte, lo que aquí ocurre esto es vandalismo.
Y en estos casos eso ante la justicia califica como una falta, que recibe como castigo una multa o bien trabajo comunitario. Los representantes en Chile de la empresa de pinturas que publica el video en YouTube no quisieron comentarlo en cámara, aseguraron que ellos no tienen vínculo con esta plataforma y que no tienen mayores antecedentes. Pregúntale a Peter contra quién compites.
On the way to Buenos Aires, we were arrested. The police took us to a jail 2,000 kilometers away in the south of Argentina. We were in jail there for 10 days. They took us out of our cell, stripped us naked, and tortured us in front of one another. They broke my finger and almost collapsed Ekin's throat. We had to pay them $14,000. Otherwise, they said that if we didn't pay, the inmates would kill us. So, we paid, and I flew home the next day I was released. After countless police chases, near-death experiences, South American jails, tropical parasites, and indescribable stress from constant action, it's safe to say it's time for a little vacation. So to my local vandal squad, and whatever Interpol detachments have been stressing you, you can relax. You won't be hearing from me anytime soon. But it's not over. It's never over.